In this video, I'll teach you how to replace an ordinary switch with a computer-controlled switch or a transistor. Why might you want to do that? What's wrong with just a manual switch? Well, let me demonstrate a couple of undesirable properties of an ordinary switch with a circuit I have here on the bench next to me. We have a DC power supply, a motor, and a normal switch. We have the DC power supply here set to 50 volts, and when I use the push button switch, the motor is going to turn on. When I was holding down the switch, all of the current that the motor was using when it was running was passing through the switch. Now, for a small motor like this, it may not make much of a difference, but for large motors, you could have a lot of current, dangerous amounts of current, passing through a switch. You might not always need to use a really large switch. Sometimes you might want to use a small switch. The second undesirable property of a normal switch is that it's manual. What if I wanted to control this motor switching on and off with a signal that comes out of a microcontroller, for example? How would I do that? Well, in order to do that, we're going to replace this manual switch with a transistor. Let me show you how to do this firstly with an NPN bipolar junction transistor. What we're going to do here is to apply either a low voltage or a high voltage at the input, and then the transistor is going to switch large amounts of current here on the right. For example, if I apply 0 volts here at the input, the transistor is going to be off. Let's say, for example, that I apply 5 volts here at the input, then the transistor will be on. Now, what do I mean by off and on? Well, what I mean is that when the transistor is on, current will flow. If it's off, then current will not flow. The transistor functions just like a switch. The current, though, to drive the motor is passing through the transistor rather than here at the base. This means that while we need to make sure the transistor is sized properly so that it can handle the current going through the motor, we don't necessarily need to have very much current passing through our user control interface or whatever circuitry leads to the input side of that transistor. If we apply 0 volts to the input side of a transistor, that transistor is going to be off. Current's not going to pass through it. But how much voltage do I need to apply to the input or to the base in order to turn the transistor on? Well, to answer that question, it depends on what kind of transistor it is. If it's a bipolar transistor and it's made from silicon, then you need about 0.7 volts or higher to turn the transistor on. If it's a MOSFET and it's an n-channel MOSFET, then you're going to have to look at the data sheet for that transistor and look for something called the threshold voltage. You need to apply more than the threshold voltage to get that transistor to turn on. An NPN transistor will be on when the voltage from one end of the arrow to the other is greater than or equal to 0.7 volts. An n-channel MOSFET will turn on when the voltage from one end of the arrow to the other is greater than the threshold voltage, which is different from MOSFET to MOSFET. When looking at these circuit diagrams and making a decision about what voltage you need to overcome, you need to make sure that the plus and minus signs of your reference voltage here are from the tail of the arrow to the head of the arrow. That's true regardless of the transistor type. So here with the bipolar junction transistor, we need to make sure that the voltage between the base and the emitter is greater than or equal to 0.7 volts to turn on the transistor. Here with the n-channel MOSFET, we need to compare the gate to the source voltage. Let's now change our demonstration circuit here and switch this motor on using the output signal of an Arduino. We have the same power supply as we had before. I'm going to go ahead and turn it on. We have it set to 50 volts. And the switch that we used to have between the motor and the power supply is now providing a digital input signal to our Arduino here. One of the output pins of our Arduino now leads to the base of a power bipolar transistor. When I click the switch, the motor is going to switch on. But in this case, all of the current required by the motor is passing through the transistor rather than through the switch. Furthermore, the small amount of current used to drive the bipolar transistor can be provided by the microcontroller. But obviously, there wouldn't be enough current provided by the microcontroller to run the motor itself. That's the power of using a transistor as a switch. Let me show you some other possible configurations. You might have noticed that one disadvantage of the current configuration is that the motor is always connected to the high voltage supply. This could be dangerous in certain situations. What if we wanted the motor to be grounded when it's off? How would we do that? We might consider using a transistor on the high side of the circuit rather than the low side, but this particular configuration won't work. Let me explain why. Imagine that our motor requires 50 volts to run. Let's imagine that our input signal, however, is either 0 volts or 5 volts. If we apply 0 volts at the base of this transistor, then the transistor is definitely going to be off. But what happens when we apply 5 volts here at the base? Is the transistor going to turn on or not? If the resistance of the motor is really small, then our transistor might turn on. But the problem with this particular circuit is that the motor probably has quite a lot of resistance. We can't be sure that although we apply 5 volts here at the input, that we're going to have 5 volts across the base emitter junction. If we apply 5 volts here at the base of the transistor, what we're really doing is applying 5 volts across both the transistor and the motor. We can't be sure that we're going to wind up with a voltage across the transistor that exceeds 0.7 volts. That depends on the resistance of the motor, and it's likely to be quite a large resistance. For this reason, this configuration of using an NPN bipolar transistor as a switch is probably not very useful. Let's take a look at another configuration that might allow you to connect the motor to the ground side of a circuit rather than the high side. If the required voltage of the motor is not very high, then it's possible to use another kind of transistor as a switch and make it work. That transistor is called a PNP transistor. If it's a bipolar transistor, that is. If it's a MOSFET, then you call it a P-channel MOSFET. Again, the voltage needed to turn on either the PNP transistor or the P-channel MOSFET can be found by referring to the little arrow drawn on the circuit diagram. For a PNP transistor, we need to make sure that the voltage across this junction exceeds 0.7 volts. And for a P-channel MOSFET, we need to make sure that the voltage exceeds whatever threshold voltage is in the datasheet of that MOSFET. Let's consider the situation here with the PNP transistor when we have either 0 volts or 5 volts at the base. First of all, if we have 5 volts here at the base of this transistor, then no current is going to pass through resistor R. Since both the base and the emitter of this transistor are at 5 volts, then we don't have the required 0.7 volts across this arrow here to turn the transistor on. 5 volts then corresponds to the off case. What happens when we have 0 volts here at the base of the transistor? With 0 volts here at the base, we do have the required 0.7 volts across that junction. The transistor should turn on. Now you might be wondering, why do I have a resistor there? Can't I just use a microcontroller and one of the digital output pins to give me the required 0 volts or 5 volts to turn the transistor on or off? The reason I have this resistor here between the base and 5 volts is so that if I float my input, then the base is effectively at 5 volts. This ensures that the transistor is switched off by default. If the input is just disconnected from the circuit, the motor is not automatically going to switch on. Hopefully now you can see how a transistor can be used as a switch in your circuits. This video is part of an organized sequence where I explore various AC and switching circuits. If you enjoyed it, then you might consider following the channel's playlist to learn more about these types of circuits.